Having us. This is Dr. Srikant from Team MDS Conquer. Now I'll be going through few stuff related to general surgery. So I'll be discussing as many as case-based and diagram-based, including with the normal discussion. I'll try to cover as much content as possible within a limitation of 30 minutes. And first of all, I'll be dropping this particular video, which is of 4 minutes, in the description part. Okay, so please do finish this video of 4 minutes, which covers all the carcinomas. And 2 questions were directly from this video in the recent NEET 2020. So please do finish this at any cost. Then comes the edges. I hope most of you are familiar with these diagrams, so they can ask you a diagram based question too. Okay. So what type of edge? A is undermined edge, whereas B is, you can see like something like a punched out. C is, you can see a slope over here, sloping edge. Okay, D is raised edge, and E is rolled and averted edge. Okay, so they can ask you the examples. The undermined edge, the best example is tuberculosis. Okay, punched out is seen in the case of gamma, that is syphilis, and in the case of an deep trophic ulcer. Sloping edge is seen in the case of a healing traumatic ulcer, whereas raised and beaded edge is a feature that is seen in the case of a rodent ulcer, that is your basal cell carcinoma. Rolled out and averted edges are seen in the case of a squamous cell carcinoma or ulcerative adenocarcinoma. This is a very important thing that you have to make out. The next comes is the floor. Floor is something what we see, that is the exposed surface of the ulcer is called as floor. Regularly, if you see, the floor is covered with a red granulation tissue that gives an idea that the ulcer is healthy and it is healing. For example, if the floor is pale and smooth granulation tissue, if it's having a pale and smooth granulation tissue, it's a slow healing ulcer. Washed leather is slug. Okay, this is a question that is given in 2019 NEET examination. That is a gummatous ulcer. Okay, or black mass at the floor, that is malignant melanoma. These are the important things that you have to make a note. And when you're talking about the base can be indurated sometimes, slightly induration or something can be present. So induration of base is a very classical feature of carcinomas. Okay, it's a very important feature of squamous cell carcinoma. Very, very important. What is the difference between a malignant ulcer and a normal ulcer is, malignant ulcers have indurations at the base. And I hope most of you are familiar with this. That is your regular punched out lesions that are seen on the radiograph, that is multiple myeloma. Whereas irregular punched out lesions are seen in the case of eosinophilic granuloma. And of course, I have discussed about the floor of the ulcer, that is red is healing ulcer. Necrotic slog is present in the case of a spreading ulcer. Pale granulation tissue is present in the case of tuberculosis ulcer. And washed leather slog is seen in the case of a gummatous ulcer, that is syphilis. The next comes with a few important areas. Most of you are well aware of this. If you have a granulation tissue that is being observed, it is non-specific healing type. If you have a slug already discussed, that is syphilis, that is an infected ulcer. If you have, this is a very important, watery apple jelly appearance are seen in the case of a tuberculosis, that is the skin, okay, tuberculosis of the skin, that is lupus vulgaris, that is lupus vulgaris. Okay, indurated was already discussed. Attached to the deep structures is a specific feature that is seen in the case of venous ulcer. And this is what we have learned, a black color thing, that is malignant melanoma. Trophic ulcer is also called as in a bed spore, that you can see the patient, they can give you the clinical feature like this. A rodent ulcer, most of you are familiar with this, that is called as in a basal cell carcinoma. It's also called as in a tear carcinoma. It's also called as tear carcinoma because it's most commonly seen in the areas where the tears will fall. Okay, this is a basal cell carcinoma. Okay, I mean, lupus vulgaris, do make a note, that is TB of skin. It's called as lupus vulgaris. The test that is useful for identification of this lupus vulgaris is match stick test. So please do learn the description if you want to learn in detail. So already discussed apple jelly bodies are seen in the case of lupus vulgaris. Do make a note, TB of lymph node is scapula, whereas the TB of spine is Pott's disease. Coming to the stress ulcers, acute duodenum ulcer that is arised from episodes of shock, sepsis and surgery and the trauma, they are called as curling ulcers. Whereas the same stress ulcers in the case of increasing in the intracranial pressure or during the intracranial pathologies or intracranial surgeries is called as Cushing's ulcer. So please do make a note of these two terminologies, which are most commonly asked questions. Mucus patches, which are seen in the case of secondary syphilis. You can see this mucus patches, which are seen in the case of secondary syphilis. The same snail tract ulcer. It's running like a snail tract, which is seen in the case of secondary syphilis. Just add a note about this. Portal vein pressures. The normal is 5 to 10 mm of HE or 10 to 15 centimeters of saline. Whenever it is more than 10 millimeters, the variceal formation occurs. Whenever it is more than 12 millimeters, the variceal bleeding occurs. Whenever it is more than 10 millimeters, it is considered as a portal hypertension. So these are the pulpal pressures which you can just compare. Normal pulpal pressure is 5 to 10 mm of HE. Reversible pressure is 13.5 mm of HE and irreversible pulpitis pressure is 34.5 millimeters of HE. And I hope most of you are familiar with this, the sinus. It is a blind tract lined by granulation tissue leading from one epithelium down into the tissue. So it has one opening down into the tissue. So sinuses can be congenital or acquired. Very simple, congenital means by birth. Acquired, most of the acquired things, whether it is a sinus or a fistula, they can be due to the infection or they can be due to the trauma. Okay, so you can see TB, that is infection. This is hair follicle infection. This is also infection. This is also infection. This is during the birth. Okay, I mean, it's a very simple that remember these things with logic. Don't waste much of your time. Fistula has two communications. Communication between one lumen of one viscera to the lumen of other. This is called as, previously we have sinus only one opening. Fistula has two openings. Same. Traumatic, inflammatory, malignant, iatrogenic are acquired. And all these are, they are congenital. I hope you are very familiar with this. This is angiogram. This is the carotid body tumor, which is present between the external and internal carotid at the bifurcation. This is originated at the bifurcation. Okay. The other names of this, do make a note. Signs which are seen. Okay, what is this sign? Moves more in the horizontal plane than in the vertical plane. Please do make a note about this sign also. So this is the location where you can see this carotid body tumor. Next is cystic hygroma, which is most commonly seen. They can give a case-based question telling that the patient immediately after birth, there is some vigorous swelling or a big swelling at the head and neck region. Okay, such this is called as a moist tumor. It is because due to the abnormality of the lymphatic system, usually bilateral, involves the posterior aspect of the neck. Clear or cloudy fluid is present. Prognosis is very, very poor. I mean, like, it may be associated with the chromosomal anomalies, and please do make a note about all the chromosomal anomalies which we've discussed when we are going through. Syndrome which is associated with cystic hygroma, all these questions were discussed at the best. So what is the treatment plan for this? Again, a case. You're going to give a sclerosing agent, so by which you can differentiate the edges, then you can plan the surgery. Next is the brachial cyst. So these are congenital cysts which are present on the lateral surface of the neck. And they may be associated close to the top of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Please do make a note about the locations. The next comes is cold abscess. Cold abscess is most commonly seen in the case of M. salt. Of course, the most important thing is TB. Okay, question was given in the recent examinations. So what is this Minerva jacket, they can ask you. So this is given for C3 to T2. So this particular type of, this is an additions test. This particular test is useful. Regularly known is this. So please do make a note of these two or three conditions where you can do this test. I was discussing the same in the oral surgery video. So these are the levels. They can ask you a diagram based question, and this was the question that is given in the 2020 NEET. Okay, and I think I mean the same question was from the table. The same question was repeated in 2018 too. This is a blowout fracture which I missed in the surgery part, the oral surgery part, so I have added here. So what are the features? You can see facial asymmetry. Okay, so please do make a note of all these values and do make a note about the muscles of the orbital movement, the muscles of orbital movement, which are innervated by what, and all these are very, very important aspects which are discussed. Regularly asked question, that is your blowout fracture. So what is tripod fracture? Tripod fracture means it's going to have something like a tripod. Okay, so the fracture of zygoma is considered as tripod fracture. It's already discussed in your surgery that zygoma is the second most common midfacial fracture. Okay, not second most common, midfacial fracture. And do make a note about this Sudan's classification, Sunderland's classification. What is neuropyrexia? What is neurotemesis? What is axonotemesis and everything? Please do make a note about the Tinel sign. And how this Sudan's classification is related to Sundance Land classification, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade 4. So all these grades comes under axonotemesis. This fifth grade comes under neurotemesis. So just try to correlate. We have discussed everything in detail when we are dealing with oral and general surgery. Of course, this is a direct question from your last year's class in the NEET 2020. Okay, that is Costan syndrome is mainly related to the temporomandibular joint. And this is a question that is given in the last year PGA direct question from your discussion part. So this is basically a Leford 3. Okay, this is a Leford 3. But see the description of the question. If the diagram given below is associated with a fracture extending the base of the skull. So any fracture that extends the base of the skull comes under the Leford 4. So all Leforts are discussed in the oral surgery. Do make a note about Leford 4 also. These are worm-like fillings which are seen after the barium meal. Okay, they are called as esophagus varices. Do not make a note about this syndrome. Okay, and these important features. Portal triad. Okay, nowadays histological based diagram based questions are being more common. It's a triad of hepatic artery, portal vein, and bile duct. Do make a note about this triad and pentads. Okay, again, a regularly most commonly asked question. And what are the features that are seen in the case of an acute arterial occlusion? Okay, so these all P's which are, okay, it moves around P's. Okay, so please do learn this. This is very, very important. What is vascular angular Burgers angle? When it's less than 30, if it should be normal. So whenever this arterial occlusion occurs, then there is some sort of abnormality. So all these various questions that are given around the Burgers disease, the other name most common in men, age of 20 to 40, smoking is the primary etiology, 20 cigars per day, low socioeconomic status group, hypercoagulable status, family history will be there. Okay, peripheral vasospasm will be there. The infection which is associated with the Burgers disease is this, mainly affecting the, this is the question given, mainly affecting the small and the medium, not the larger arteries. Okay, not the larger arteries, mainly affecting the deep arteries. What is foot claudication? What is pain? All these are important. Like all these are important. The tree roots or spider roots are seen in the case of all these are a collection of questions given in various examinations related to this particular disease. Do make a note about what is Ellen's test and what is modified Ellen's test. This is basically used to know the collateral circulation. Okay, so if the same part is being supplied by two different arteries by compressing one artery and relieving other artery, you will know which artery has a defect. And coming to the vitals, primary vitals, okay, there are four primary vitals. That is your body temperature, heart rate or pulse, respiratory rate, and body pressure, blood pressure. And coming to the fifth vital sign, pain is considered as a fifth vital sign. Sometimes you can take any of these into consideration. Nowadays, the fifth vital sign is considered as an oxygen saturation because of COVID-19 by pulse oximetry. You can consider the blood glucose level or menstrual cycle. The next comes the sixth vital sign. So all these are considered as a sixth vital sign. So please do make a note about the first four, followed by the fifth vital sign, followed by the sixth vital sign. So please do make a note about this diagram based question. This is the type of flap that is useful for the lip. This is one more flap that is useful for the lip. What is Commando's operation? That is basically to treat the infiltrated mandible or the floor of the mouth. Okay, so where you're going to remove everything, the part of tongue, floor of the mouth, hemi mandibularectomy, and total block dissection of the same side. So this is sphygmomanometer. Okay, what you're going to do, so in this case the width of this cuff will be more than the diameter. Okay, so you can see the width of the cuff, this is the width of the cuff, will be more, the width will be more when compared to the diameter. How much it is more? 20% is more. We have discussed this, okay, it's very, very important. We have discussed different parameters when I'm talking about the pedo, because this question given in many state entrance examinations. This is a normal value, and please do make a note about less than 1 year and a range of 2 to 3 years. All these, the lower limits also. BMI is again a question, basing upon the weight, 2018 NEET question, basing upon the weight and height. And to make a note, as a screening device for weight categories that may be associated with the health problems, BMI is used as a screening tool, but not as a diagnostic tool. It's not a diagnostic tool, it's just a screening tool. So what are the values? Underweight, normal weight, overweight, obese, all this. This is a question that is given in 2018 NEET, if I'm not wrong. So how do you calculate formulas? So you have two formulas in 2020 NEET. Two formulas. What are they? One is Young's rule. Young's rule of drug calculation is one formula that is given. Second one is Parkland's formula in your oral surgery. That is fluid replacement. Two formulas are given. So do make a note about these formula. There are high chances that one more formula can come into 021. Basic life support. Okay, so basic life support is basically A, B, C, D. But in 2010, it is just being modified or drifted to CAB. Okay, that is C, A, B, D. Make sure P is first important. So before you start compressions, make sure the patient is in proper position. So P is position, C for circulation, A for airway, B for breathing, and D for definite care. This is a Torenki test. This is multiple means at different levels. At different levels, you're going to do this test by which you will know where the incompetence is. And do make a note about this Raynaud's disease. What is primary? What is secondary? Okay, these are something called as an accessory lacrimal glands. Okay, so please do make a note about these accessory lacrimal glands. Dimensions are not that important. These are different terms which moves around your ENT. Okay, so because partially syllabus point of ENT is again a point of syllabus. So please do make a note of all these four terms. Most of you are well familiar with glaucoma scale. Okay, all the parameters and everything. Eye opening, the reaction, verbal reaction, motor reaction and everything. So apart from those, these three again are the trauma scorings, which are very, very important. RTS, we have all discussed this. You can remember with a word called as GBR, that is glaucoma scale, blood pressure, respiratory rate. The next one is TRISS. You can remember with a keyword called as IRAM. I for injury, severity score, R for RTC, RTS, that is nothing but this. A for ACE and mechanism of injury. The next goes is MESS, that is mingled extremities severity score, that is ELISA. Energy of the cause, limb ischemia, shock, and ACE. Nitrogen balance is again an important thing. What is taken in what is going out. If it is in is more, that is called as positive. If out is more, then it's called as a negative. Positive nitrogen balance is seen in the case of all positive things, and negative nitrogen balance is seen in the case of all negative things. So positive nitrogen balance is seen in the case of growing child, pregnant women, and recovery from severe illness. All these are positive things. A negative nitrogen balance is seen in the case of malnutrition, inadequate protein, destruction of bodies, or during the fever or during the injury. That is called as negative things. So please do make a note about the positive nitrogen balance, negative nitrogen balance. So the factors which influence the nitrogen balance, that positive nitrogen balance are the growth hormone and insulin. Negative nitrogen balance are the carcinomas, cancer, and uncontrolled diabetes. And of course, this is an important thing which we have learned in many areas. Okay, in many areas. Okay, so please do have a quick recap. Like the slight differences between the American Heart Association, or the slight difference between the British Cardiac Society. But do make a note. They are very, very important areas of questions. Okay, all this we have learned. Okay, I think this is the question that is given in 2020 NEET. Right, 2020 NEET. So this is a question given in AIIMS, recent AIIMS. The question was given. So all these questions, this is a table of interest, table of focus, have to be done at your best. So if it is IV, it should be given before 30 minutes. If it is normal, okay, oral, it is given 1 hour. Okay, of course, it's a most of these are direct questions from your sessions last year. This is again 2020 NEET question. Okay, so this is the run out. Okay, so do make a note. This is the run out diagram. Okay. This is also called as a rebounding phenomenon, which is seen in the case of peritonitis. Of course, you are well familiar with this Laskin signs, so please do make a note about this for Laskin signs, which helps in identifying MPDS. And of course, this is a modified Jukes criteria. Okay, so what is the major, what is the minor criteria? So please go with the Jukes criteria, which is very, very important, which is useful to identify the infective endocarditis. The next comes is the Jones criteria, which is useful to identify the rheumatic fever. So what are the major aspects? What are the minor aspects? Do make a note. Then comes the one more criteria, Outlet's criteria, which is a criteria used in diagnosing the single sitting root canal treatment. Yeah, I'm done for now. Signing off, Dr. Srikant from Team MDS Conquer. Do make a note. Don't miss your thyroid carcinomas 4 minutes video. The link will be shared in the description. All the best. Stay positive.